Hey guys, this is Jordan from LearnUXD, and welcome to the first episode of the Designer's Toolkit. Today we're going to be using Miro to make a sitemap. A sitemap is a really useful tool when you're figuring out an information architecture. It shows the pages of an app and helps us lay out a structure for everything that will make sense to the user. It's also really useful for other people on the team like product managers and developers. Miro is awesome for this because it makes it really easy to crank out the pieces of a sitemap quickly and then share it with your team so you can work together on it. So let's imagine we're a UX designer at a clothing company and we're assigned to design a new mobile app that will let people shop on their phones. One of the first things we need to figure out is how we're going to structure this app, so we need to make a sitemap. Okay, this is our Miro board. We've got an infinite canvas, and I find the easiest way to move around is to just hold spacebar and click and drag. To zoom, you hold command or control and scroll. We've got some general info and settings at the top. Down here are some sharing features and navigation tools, which I'm going to hide for now. And on the left is our main toolbar. Now, Miro has lots of templates, including one for a sitemap, but I'm going to start from scratch for this project. Okay, let's assume we did some user interviews beforehand, and we know that what our users want is to be able to pull up the app and immediately start shopping. So we'll create what we'll call an explore page with stuff like recommended products, search field, product collections, and make that the home page. I'm going to put these pages in what Miro calls shapes. So I'll hit S on my keyboard and just click where I want the shape to go. I'm going to adjust how this first one looks, and when I do that, Miro will make all the shapes we do in the future have the same styling. Like I mentioned, we'll have a search bar on the explore page, so we'll put the search results page right here below the explore page so that the hierarchy is clear. We want to show the connection between these two pages, so we'll create what Miro calls a connection line between these two shapes by hitting L on the keyboard and clicking the two nodes where we want the line to show up. The great thing about these connection lines is they stay put no matter where we move the shape, which is so much better than having to manually adjust the lines every time you move stuff around, like you'd have to do in something like Figma. So once the user lands on the search results page, we'll give them a way to filter those results. So we'll put the filtering page off to the side at the same level. Another thing we'll have on the explore page are links to specific clothing lines and collections, which, by the way, we categorized using card sorting, which we also did in Miro. We'll put that here on the same level as the search results page. And finally, we'll have recommended products on the explore page, so we'll stick that on this same level as well. I've put it here in between the other pages because you can also get to the individual product page from these other pages, and we're going to show that by putting connection lines between them. So we know this is the home page, but we're planning on having a bottom nav bar like lots of mobile apps out there. Let's put the nav up here like this to give some clarity of how this is all structured. We'll make the shape different though so that it's clear that this isn't a page. A common scenario we learned from those user interviews is that users just get on and window shop without buying anything. We have a way to mark a product as a favorite, so we'll dedicate a navbar link to your favorites list and put it right over here. Obviously, the main business goal and general point of this app is merchandise sales, so we'll dedicate another main nav item to that and add a checkout page. And the last link in the navbar will be an account page with several subpages like preferences and support. One more thing to think about as far as content goes. When a user first downloads the app, they're going to have to create an account or log in. So up here, I'm going to make splash, sign up, and login pages. These technically sit outside of the normal flow of things though, because they aren't there most of the times that the user will be opening the app. So I'm going to put a sticky note here to make sure we remember that and also not include connection lines. A few of these pages are connected, like when a user adds an individual product to their cart and then goes from there to the cart. So I'm going to create a link between them for reference, and we'll want to make these lines a little different and make sure they don't cross over something else. Okay, we're pretty much done with structure, so let's look at a couple other very useful things we can do with this in Miro. A lot of the time, one of the next steps you're going to take after making a sitemap is drawing up wireframes. And we can actually pull all those wireframes into this sitemap to get a clearer picture of how everything feels and works together. Apps like Figma and Sketch even have plugins that help you sync your designs with a Miro board. Once we transfer in the wireframes, we need to label them since we don't have the label inside the shape anymore. We can just hit T on the keyboard and click where we want the text to go. Let's put it all inside a frame so we can easily export it or share it in presentation mode on Miro. I'll just hit F on the keyboard and click and drag where we want it to go. Now comes one of my favorite parts of Miro. We've reached the point where we need to get feedback from our teammates and start iterating, so I'll bring in my product manager and we can start sharing notes and ideas back and forth in real time right on this board. There's a bunch of stuff we can do, like adding more sticky notes, including tags, links out to other resources and reactions. We can write comments. We can work together on a little documentation. And we can chat or even have a built-in video call right in Miro. And once it's ready to show the rest of the team, we can put it in presentation mode or share our screen to show other people like developers. All right, that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. You can check out Miro at miro.com. It's a great tool, very flexible and perfect for working together with your teammates. More Designer's Toolkit videos will be coming out, so be sure to stay tuned. And for lots of other UX tutorials, check out learnuxd.io.